Welcome to Strength of Materials, Simple Stress and Strain. So in this video, I'll be taking for the analysis of varying sections, how we are going to analyze. So in this figure, we are able to see that there are the particular sections are given, such as area 1 is one section, area 2 is another section, area 3 is another section, which are having the different length as L1, L2 and L3. Also, we can see that the load is acting common, which is equal and opposite in direction. So, we are able to see that it is under a tension loading. So, tension loading is acting on the particular bars of the section. Now these section bars may be of circular section or may be of square section or may be of any other section. That time the area will change. So area, so let us consider the section number 2. So for the area 2, if I consider, so this as the circular bar and this as the square bar, if I take this as the square bar. Okay, so now what will be happening? Area 1, A1 will be equal to square, that is length into breadth will be the area for the A1, means the square section. And for area 2, if I consider, this will be the pi by 4 into d square, if the diameter is known to us, if not, we have to proceed with the radius. If radius is also given, 2 times of the radius is known as diameter. So this way the area are going to change, but they will not go away from the sections. We can only split them for the convenience of the loading pattern. Means if this force is acting, the one force is also acting on in this direction from the point A only. So when this force is acting, there is a reaction from A2. So reaction from A2, if I consider, that will be acting in the opposite direction. So it will be acting in this direction. Now when A2, from the reaction of A2 is acting, similar, the A2 is going to exhibit another force this way. So this particular force and this particular force both are same, which is on the equal and opposite side. When we come to section number 3, that time another force is going to act, which is again opposite to the A2 section force, which is acting away from the A3 but acting on A2. So this way it will be converted to this particular P value. So now we are able to see that both side, both the ends, P is same. So in between, whatever these two forces are going to come, they will be equal to same as P itself only. There is no change. If there is a change of force is there, then we have to take this into account and we have to find out, as we have done in the problems. Clear? So this is the derivation part. So how to get the equation for analysis of bars for varying sections. Moving further, the total change in length will be obtained by adding the changes in the length of individual section. Let P is equals to actual load acting on the bar, L1 is equals to length of the section 1. So it is length of the section 1 what we have to consider. Similarly, A1 is equals to cross-sectional area of section 1. And if I go for further two sections, it will be L2 and A2, length and cross-sectional area of section 2, L3 and A3, length and cross-sectional area of section 3. So these are the considerations what we are going to consider. E as Young's modulus for the bar, which is constant, if it is constant. If it is not constant, again we have to consider E1, which is Young's modulus of section number 1, E2 as Young's modulus of section number 2, E3 as Young's modulus of section number 3, in the similar pattern. Stress for the section number 1. What is the stress? What we are going to consider for the stress? So we know that stress is equals to sigma is equals to P by A in terms of formulation. Stress is exactly, we know that, load resistance by the particular cross-sectional area. load resistance by the particular cross-sectional area is known as the stress. Clear? So if we plot this particular part in the stress, why we are considering stress? P is known to us, area A1 is known to us, we can easily plot the particular formulation as stress. Clear? For that reason, stress for the section number 1. Sigma 1 is equals to load upon area of section 1 will be coming as P divided by A1 is the sigma 1. Similarly, stresses for the section 2 and section 3 are also given as sigma 2 P divided by A2 and sigma 3 P divided by A3. So, this is the stress part. Now, using the equations, the strains in a different sectional are obtained as what is now strain. Now, when we consider the stress, load is acting and load upon area we have calculated the stress. When load is acting, there is something known as the strain is also going to act. So, this strain, how we are able to find this particular strain? We have already one equation, Young's modulus, capital E. So, Young's modulus is equals to sigma, that is stress upon strain. Stress upon strain. So, we can use this stress upon strain equation. So, this strain will become as stress upon Young's modulus. As Young's modulus is common to all the sections. As Young's modulus is common to all the sections or same to all the three sections. Therefore, strain of section number 1 is equals to E1 divided is equals to sigma 1 divided by E, capital E. Therefore, it is P by A1 into E. What is P by A1? I am going to substitute, means we are going to substitute in place of stress, sigma. Okay, how it will be substituted? We know that E is equals to sigma is what? This is P by A. So, this P by A, if I substitute P upon A and E is in the denominator side. So, this A is A1 and E is in the denominator side. Finally, we are able to get this particular equation. So, this equation is here. Clear? E strain as P upon A up in 1 into E. That is P divided by area into Young's modulus. Similarly, strains of the section 2 and section 3. E2 is equals to sigma 2 upon E, it is P upon A2 into capital E, and sigma E3, strain 3, strain in the third section is equals to sigma 3 upon E is equals to P upon A3 into capital E. E is Young's modulus, I repeat, okay. Now, we have strain as E is equals to change in length upon original length. What is now change in length? Change in length is DL. Change in length is this particular DL. We have studied strain as change in length upon original length. Now, how we can say that this is change in length upon original length can give us the analysis of various sections of bars, means the change in the dimension can also be determined by the similar formula. Therefore, E1 is equals to DL1 upon L1, where DL1 is change in length of section number 1. So, when the force is acting, that time we can say that there is something change in the length. So, that change in length, we are taking it as DL1. We are taking it as DL1, the change in length of section number 1. Clear? So, what we can write this in terms of? Therefore, change in length of the section number 1, we can write it as DL1 into E1L1. Now, what is this DL1? It is change in length of section 1. What is the E1? Excuse. E1 is the strain. E1 is the strain what we have seen. Strain in the particular section number 1. That is P divided by A1 into E. And what is L? L is original length of the section number 1. Considering this, if we write dl1 is equals to PL1 divided by A1 E1. What is now strain? Strain is already known to us that it is P by, strain is already known to us, that is P upon A1 E. So therefore we write E1 is equals to P upon A1 E. So this, when we substitute into the particular formula in place of E1, we get the value of dl1 is equals to pl1 by a1 into e. Similarly, change in the length of section 2 and section 3 also we can write as change in length of section 2, dl2 is equals to e2 l2, that is dl2 is equals to pl2 by a2 e. This is because E2 is P by A2 into E. Therefore, change in length of section number 3, we can write it as DL3 is equals to E3 L3. Then that DL3 is equals to PL3 divided by A3 capital E. Because E3 is, that is strain in the section 3. P by A3 into E. So this is nothing but the strain part. This is strain part in section 2. This is strain part in section 3. This is change in length of section 2, change in length of section 3. The final equation what we are going to see. Now we have determined individual change in length of all the three sections. Individual means separate. Now for the total change in length of the sections, we need to sum up them. So therefore total change on the length of the bar will be delta L or delta L. DL or delta L is known as the formula or the symbol to get the change in length. What we can write? DL1 plus DL2 plus DL3, which is equals to PL1 by A1 E1 plus PL2 by A2 E plus PL3 by A3 E is the three equations of individual three sections. When we club them, we are able to see that P divided by capital E, E and E as the common value, as the common value. So substituting this in terms of common value, we find out DL is equals to P upon E into bracket L1 by A1 plus L2 by A2 plus L3 by A3. This is equation number 1. What we are going to find? The total change in length of the bar. Now when is this equation going to be used? Above equation is used when Young's modulus of different section is same. Also, there are some changes that the load may not be same. If the load is same, then only the equation 1 is going to satisfy. Or else, we have to go with the above equation, which is as equation A, small a, with this equation, where P will also count as P1, E will also called as E1. That time we have to write the equation, that is change in length of delta first bar or first section will be P1 L1 divided by A1 E1. So here P is separate, length is separate, area is separate, and Young's modulus is separate for all the other three sections also. Similarly, if the Young's modulus of different section is different, then the total change in length of the bar is given by DL is equals to P as L in bracket L1 divided by A1 E1 plus L2 divided by A2 E2 plus L3 divided by A3 E3. This is the final second equation where P is only common, Young's modulus are again separate for all the three sections in this manner. So we can see that now. Therefore, the total change in the length of the bar as per the first equation, dl is equals to p by e l1 a1 plus l2 a2 plus l3 a3. This is when the e is same, means Young's modulus is same in this part of this section, the second loading. Clear? This way is same in this first section. When we go for the second one, dl is equals to p l1 by a1 e1 plus l2 by a2 e2 plus l3 by a2 e3. This is when Young's modulus is different for all the three sections. Third section can also be derived as p, taking all the loads separate. Moreover, if we remember these two formulations, the third can be easily formulated. This was the analysis of bar for varying sections under common load and Young's modulus same, as also the separate Young's modulus. Thank you and see you in the next video.